most of what we know about the universe does come to us through light, through what we can see. And we can see an extraordinary cosmos with incredible inhabitants and all kinds of remarkable events going on in the universe. But it's important to realize the universe isn't a silent film, because space itself wobbles and rumbles like a drum in response to all of these things unfolding in the cosmos. I'm Janna Levin. I'm a professor of physics and astronomy at Barnard College. Strictly speaking, if you're a sci-fi fan, and you see someone screaming, you know they don't make a sound. There's no air in space to compress, to ring against your ear. But if space itself is ringing and squeezing and stretching, your eardrum can resonate in response to that squeezing and stretching. It would literally displace your ear. You could hear the sound of very dramatic events in the universe. So there's a close analogy with the idea that space can ring and that there's a soundtrack to the universe. In this ambition to capture songs from the universe, we turn our focus to black holes and the promise they have, because black holes can bang on space-time like mallets on a drum. By the time they get to the Earth, this can't happen. It's way too quiet, way too pale in echo. But we can design experiments that can pick up the ringing of space, the ringing of the drum. And once they record the motion of space, you can plug that into a stereo system and play back the sound. Imagine a lighter black hole falling into a very heavy black hole. The sound you're hearing is a light black hole banging on space each time it gets close. If it gets far away, it's a little too quiet, but it comes in like a mallet and it literally cracks space, wobbling it like a drum, and we can predict what the sound will be.
What it does is it changes, I think, the way that we see ourselves in the world. We realize that there are things out there that have not yet been seen, that can only be heard. It gives us a deeper understanding into the universe, maybe even the origins of the universe. And I think that that's a pilgrimage human beings have been on ever since they started to look out and wonder about the world.